Number 7. Raju and Ishtar Khan. While cleaning a 13-story property in India, Raju and Ishtar Khan accidentally broke a panel, prompting them to fall approximately 100 feet to the ground. The window washers were using a hydraulic lift without the proper safety gear. They suffered massive trauma to the head. Their injuries were so severe that first responders couldn't do anything to save their lives. They died on the spot. Police promptly began an investigation, obtaining footage of the accident. An officer told the media that arrests would be made, mainly involving negligence on the part of the employer. The average high-rise window washer can earn anywhere between $35,799 and $89,917 annually. This number increases exponentially for skilled and experienced workers, who can make over $198,333. Though the job offers great views and flexibility, there's also a high risk of severe or fatal injuries. Faulty safety gear can lead to deadly accidents, and sudden climate shifts can prove disastrous. Though the death rate used to be significantly higher before the 21st century, traumas suffered during falls can have lifelong consequences. Number 6. Kwok Ki Koon. Kwok Ki Koon was part of a group of divers in charge of performing underwater survey works for several vessels at a Singapore port. Koon was responsible for cleaning the ship's portholes. These are used to cool down engines by sucking in seawater during navigation. While welding anodes in the sea chest box, the porthole activated, trapping Koon inside. By the time the pump was deactivated, it was already too late. Koon was declared dead at the scene. The prosecutor in charge of the incident reported that it could have been avoided. Underwater contractor, the company in charge of the operation, was also charged and fined. It's estimated that about 15% of underwater welders perish while on the job. The death rate is astonishingly high, with 5 out of 3,000 workers suffering fatal injuries every year. The salary is equally high, as most underwater welders earn up to $300,000 annually. It's a highly demanding job, requiring great skill and concentration. Drowning is the most common cause of death. An oxygen cord being twisted or breaking can yield fatal outcomes. These can be in the form of disabling injuries and, in more extreme cases, death. Though electrocution isn't as common as people might believe, it's still possible when proper safety precautions aren't applied. Number 5. Unnamed train conductor. In June of 2020, a spokesman for the Canadian National Railway Union announced one of their workers had suffered a fatal injury in a rail yard. The train conductor's name wasn't released, but it was reported he was in his 30s and had been employed by the CN since 2018. This was the second fatality to occur during the month of June. Both conductors had been performing switching operations when the accidents took place. The company refused to publicly announce the causes of death. The Transportation Safety Board in British Columbia was called to investigate both incidents. With a yearly salary of up to $80,390, railroad conductors are responsible for the safety of countless passengers every day. Though safety measures have greatly improved over the past few decades, injuries and fatal accidents are still higher than in most other high-paying jobs. In 2011, it was reported that around 187 per 10,000 workers were harmed every year. This is dramatically higher than the usual rate for switch operators and engineers, which is between 68 and 79 per 10,000. In order to become a railroad conductor, a certification is required, as well as between 1 to 3 months of specialized training, depending on the area. Number 4. Parker Waldridge. Parker Waldridge had been working on the oil fields from the age of 16 and was highly respected in this domain. At the time of his death, he was 60 years old and employed as a well site consultant. According to his wife, Waldridge was obsessed with safety and had never shown any concern about being injured while at the job. He was one of 5 workers to perish in an explosion in Oklahoma. Their bodies were ravaged beyond recognition and had to be identified using dental records. The victims' families were awarded $20 million after they filed a wrongful death lawsuit. The average salary for an oil well driller was estimated at $99,175 in 2011. This number could be doubled for highly skilled workers, with drilling consultants and reservoir engineers earning $230,000 and $139,000 respectively. The average wage for workers with less than a year's experience is still over $66,000. These high salaries come with high mortality rates. From 2008 to 2017 alone, 1,566 people died while on this job in the US alone. Blowouts are the most common cause of death, but other types of accidents may also occur. These incidents include falling pulleys, electrocution, falling from great heights, and being struck by collapsing objects. Number 3. Mahmoud Ur-Rehman. Mahmoud Ur-Rehman was one of many linemen to lose his life due to safety issues while on the job in Pakistan. While repairing a wiring problem in one of his village's power lines, Ur-Rehman suffered a powerful electric shock. Bystanders rushed the lineman to Haripur Hospital, but there was nothing the doctors could do to help him. He was declared dead upon arrival. Ur-Rehman's demise caused uproar among electrical power linemen all across the country. The Hydro Union demanded better conditions, as well as proper equipment and improved safety measures. Omar Ayub Khan, Pakistan's Minister of Power, announced a report would be submitted regarding the incident. Family members demanded a full investigation be conducted. Linemen are responsible for maintaining and repairing power lines in every city and town across the globe. They often work in harsh weather conditions and deal with damaged electrical wiring. Because of this, the risk of being electrocuted is high. The probability is increased when linemen lack sufficient training, equipment, or supervision. It's not unusual for companies to cut down expenses to the detriment of their workers' health. Since they usually deal with emergencies, linemen tend to be under high stress in a line of work where small mistakes can prove fatal. Another common cause of death and injury for linemen are falls, since they're usually required to climb to great heights. Their average yearly salary is $72,520, and the fatality rate is around 19 to 21 deaths per 100,000 workers. It's considered to be among the 10 most dangerous jobs in America. Today's topic, along with a load of other topics, was requested by Guyaran. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comments section below. Number 2. Deaths in space. Most aerospace fatalities have occurred on the ground or within Earth's atmosphere, before the aircraft managed to break through into outer space, or during practice missions. Three astronauts, though, have perished outside the Kármán line up until 2020. This is the boundary that separates our planet from the rest of the cosmos, set at 62 miles above sea level. Georgi Dobrovolsky, Vladislav Volkov, and Viktor Patsayev perished when a cabin vent valve opened due to a construction defect. A recovery team was deployed, but the decompression had already proven fatal for the Soyuz 11 crew. Though the space shuttle Columbia disintegrated during re-entry, the tragic crash occurred within the Earth's atmosphere. In 2020, an astronaut's salary can be anywhere between $66,167 and $161,141 per year. Though this might be a tempting figure, few people manage to fulfill all the requirements the job demands. Apart from having a bachelor's degree in engineering, math, computer, biological, or physical science, candidates are expected to be in peak physical condition, to be in the right age range, and to have completed at least 1,000 hours of piloting. Training is brutal, and only a small percentage of those who apply are selected. This is because any small mistake can prove deadly, both while in training and during actual missions. Structural faults, human errors, weather conditions, along with many other factors, may cause decompression, explosion, and other fatal incidents. Before we move on, official They Will Kill You merchandise is now available at theywillkillyou.com. It's out of this world. Number 1. Esti Octavia Wara Hapsari. In 2016, Dr. Octavia Wara Hapsari, a 24-year-old vet working at a tourist resort in central Java, died after being trampled by one of the elephants under her care. She was taking pictures and left the area, leaving her phone behind. When she realized it was missing, Hapsari returned to fetch it, but this seemed to startle the wild animal. Though the elephant had remained calm at first, it turned on its handler and promptly attacked Hapsari, who was standing nearby. It lifted the vet using its trunk and then threw her violently onto the ground. The young woman succumbed to her severe injuries before she could receive life-saving medical attention. The endangered Sumatran elephant had a history of becoming violent without any warning signs. Veterinarians who attend to large and exotic animals can earn a starting salary of anywhere from $75,000 to $85,000. this figure quickly progresses to an average of $150,000. Being attacked or accidentally hurt by one of their patients is a very real threat. The animal's size alone makes this a dangerous profession, without taking into account each species' specific characteristics. Being exposed to hazardous chemicals and gases, as well as lifting heavy objects, can also lead to long-term trauma and even death. Infections and envenomation, along with other illnesses, can also put the veterinarian's lives at risk. These professionals can work with a wide variety of species, including farm animals and those in zoos or natural reserves. Thanks for watching. Would you rather work for 10 years in a high mortality job or 40 years in a monotonous, risk-free career? Let us know in the comments section below.